Hi everyone, this is Sherry from Planning Peep and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing my memory spread for the week of February 4th through February 10th and I have a really, really pretty kit this week and it's from Hello Petite Paper. I absolutely love this shop. Her artwork is always really unique because she does hand draw everything and I just recently made another purchase from her that I'm really excited about, so I can't wait for that order to arrive and to share that with you guys. So anyways, for this week I have this Foxy kit and the quote box down here says, "Stay curious," and I love the combination of the pinks and the blues. Here we have the washi and washi strips. We've got little things and half boxes on this page, and then a sheet of these little headers as well as glitter headers. On this page, we have the full box checklist, and then the last page has all the functional items like some flags, some appointment labels, a weekend banner, some circle icons, and then these really cute scalloped check flags. So I think those are really adorable. For this week, I'm just going to be pulling in my Simply Gilded bow washi. I'm going to use these as little headers throughout the week, and then I know this sheet does come with glitter headers already, but I found some in my collection from Mandy Dreams that I thought would work really well with the kit. So I picked these three colors, the dark blue, the light blue, and the pink. And these ones are on glossy paper, which makes it just a little bit brighter. So I think I'm gonna opt for the Mandy Dreams headers instead of the ones that are on this header sheet. But aside from that, I think that's pretty much it for this week's setup. And I'm just gonna go ahead and get started. I decided to use both of the bottom washi strips that came in the kit because I just thought they were so pretty together. I think the navy blue with the pink just makes such a nice combination. And then moving to the sidebar, first I put down the full box in the top corner with the quote, as I usually do. And then I found these date covers in my collection. I think these are from Hazel Sticker and they're gold foiled, which is so pretty. And then I also found these little date dots that are gold foiled, and I think those are from Simply Watercolor Co. Continuing with my sidebar, I put down a glitter header with a habit tracker to track my working out, and then I use one of the appointment labels from the kit with a heart checklist, which only has 6 hearts, and I'm using it as like a weekly tracker, so I really needed 7. But I figured I could just combine the weekend into the last heart and it was gonna be fine. And then at the bottom, I put down an odds and ends header with another heart checklist to mark my dinners. And again, I just figured that I would squeeze Saturday and Sunday onto one heart. I also pulled in a gold foil heart from Clever Gal Crafts to add some foiling to my sidebar. Then moving on to Monday, first I started by putting down a today header from the kit, and I pulled in this quarter box, which is from Shop Jessica Hearts. It actually came in like a little quarter box sheet. I decided to add a gold foiled bow from Clever Gal Crafts to mark my friend's birthday, and initially I wanted to put the bow like on top in the center, but it just didn't fit well, so I ended up putting it on this side. And the brush lettering pen that I'm using this week is from Pilot. This has been my new favorite brush lettering pen, and I just love the way that it writes. And then underneath that, I put down a coffee sticker from Fox and Pip to mark that I got coffee on that Monday. And then I used a Meal Little Things to mark that I went and got some pad thai for lunch. I don't always, or I don't frequently go off campus for lunch, so it's always kind of a treat when I get to do that. I used a strip of the Simply Gilded washi and then placed the full box underneath. On Monday, it started raining halfway through the day. This year, we've gotten a ton of rain here in SoCal. That Mochi holding an umbrella sticker is from Mochi Kichi, and I think it's so cute. And then I used a glitter header underneath that. At the bottom, I put down a half box to mark where we got dinner. And then above that, I used a Little Things with a dumbbell sticker from Dizzy Daisy Dreams to mark my workout. So Monday was actually the Lunar New Year Eve, and so my boyfriend and I went and got some hot pot. It's pretty customary to have hot pot on the New Year's Eve, and that hot pot sticker is from Hazel Sticker. It was really, really good, but we definitely had quite a lot of the soup base left over, so we brought it home and then had hot pot for like the next 2 or 3 nights, so it actually was perfect. And then I decided to switch out the workout sticker. That shoe sticker is from the same Dizzy Daisy Dreams sheet as the dumbbells. On Tuesday, I started by putting down a glitter header, and then I used the full box that is the navy blue. Underneath that, I put down a half box. I then pulled in this gold foil heart from Clever Gal Crafts to mark that it was the Lunar New Year. Of course, we don't get the day off because it's not really celebrated here in the US, but you know, it's just kind of nice to mark in my planner. And then I put down a like to-do header and used a gold foiled remember sticker over it. That is from Rose Color Days. And then I used a flag from the kit with a gold foiled like exclamation mark icon. That's from Planning World to mark that I had to go pick up something from our district office on that day. I then had a staff meeting, so I wanted to mark that. The Bow Paperclip sticker is from Very Cute Designs, and I'm running out of those, so I definitely need to restock. For the bottom section, I cut down a heart checklist into three hearts, and then I found these gold foiled heart checklists from, I think that's from Paper Blush Bar, and I just decided to put that right over the hearts on the checklist and add a little gold foiling to that. Above that, I used a personal header, and then I just write down some things that I did after work on Tuesday. One of the things I did was working out, so I pulled in this Workout Girl sticker from Thule Plans, and I think she's so cute. I totally wish that I looked that cute when I'm working out because I definitely do not. But anyways, on Wednesday, I put down this full box with the fox, and I think it's so cute. I love that little fox drawing. And above that, I put down a glitter header, which, like I said, is from Mandy Dreams. I then moved back to the top and first started by putting down a strip of the Simply Gilded Washi. I decided to pull it in every other day so it's not like super overwhelming, but just enough to add some feminine bows throughout the spread. I used an appointment label with a pencil sticker from Nikki Plus 3 to mark that I had a testing appointment that day. And then I used a half box with an IEP flag from Lily Grove Designs to mark an IEP meeting that I had. Underneath that, I put down a shoe sticker, which I believe is from Sticker Sis, and then I put down a flag closer to the bottom of the remaining space, and above that, I used a little things initially with a grocery icon from Sparkly Studio, but because it was quite large and took up a lot of space, I ended up switching it out for another grocery icon from, I think that's from Very Cute Designs. At this point, I decided to remove the hot pot from Monday, and I decided to use it on Wednesday instead. That other hot pot sticker I pulled in is also from Hazel Sticker, and she honestly makes like the best food stickers. They look so cute and are so perfect to mark any kind of food you want. I actually recently joined her PR team, so if you're interested in checking out her shop, make sure to check my description box below for a coupon code for her shop. On Thursday, I started by putting down a today header at the top, and then I used a flag from the kit with a bow sticker from Very Cute Designs again to mark a morning meeting that I had on Thursday. I did not bring lunch on Thursday, so I ended up going off campus to grab some coffee and a sandwich. So I used that toast sticker from Happy Dia Stickers, and then I switched out the today header at the top for a glitter header instead. In continuing with my spread, I put down another quarter box from Shop Jessica Hearts, and then I pulled in this really cute cat holding an alarm sticker from Echo Hui Craft Co. to mark a meeting that I had later in the day. Underneath that, I put down a full box with a half box over that just because it's really hard to see my writing on like that dark navy color. And I also pulled in an IEP flag from J'adore Planning. And then that night, my boyfriend and I did Korean barbecue at home. We have like a little grill that we use, which is like perfect for cooking all the meat. And that Korean barbecue sticker is from Hazel Sticker. Like I said, she just has like the best little doodles for any kind of food you might want. And then at the bottom, I put down a couple strips of washi and then pulled in that Me Time gold foiled sticker, which is also from Hazel Sticker, with a laptop sticker from Tickled Pink Planning to mark that I just did some Me Time slash self-care, which is usually YouTube binging or buying stickers pretty much. And then moving to Friday, I first put down a today header at the top, and then I used a flag sticker from the kit, and originally I had pulled in this gold foil balloon sticker from Stella Bow Sticker Co., but I do later switch that out, so I'll explain that in a second. On Friday, I decided to pick up some pastries from 85 Bakery, which is a Taiwanese bakery, for my coworkers because they've never had like Asian breads before, and I just wanted to introduce them to that because it's amazing. And I also pulled in a gold foil heart from Hazel Sticker. I then decided to put a full box at the very top. So I peeled everything up and then laid down this really pretty pink full box. At the top of it, I put down this pretty gold foiled bow sticker that is from Clever Gal Crafts. And then I used my Pilot brush lettering pen to write in Hello Friday on the full box. I then put down another strip of the Simply Gilded washi, and then underneath that I replaced the little things where I had written 85 Degree Bakery. To mark our staff meeting, I used a Pencils in a Cup sticker from Lemon Paper Co., and that was a meeting where I got to share the baked goods with my coworkers, and everybody just loved it. They all love like different things, but they were super excited by it. And then I put down an appointment label with a phone sticker that came in the kit to mark that I had to call a parent with a staff member. And then I used a half box from the kit with another IEP flag from Lily Grove Designs to mark an IEP meeting. I then realized that I took up too much space and I needed to remove a couple things, so I ended up removing the little things with the phone call, and I also switched out the half box to a blue color instead because I wanted there to be more light blue in that section. I then put down a navy blue glitter header with a little things to mark that I stopped by Trader Joe's real quick. And then we went to a friend's house to do our monthly girls' night, which was really fun. And to mark that, I used a bow icon sticker from White Deer Stationery. I then decided to switch the glitter header and the little things to pink instead. And then at the bottom of Saturday, I placed down that navy full box. And then I'm not quite sure why I keep switching things around. I think I was just feeling extra particular on this day because I love this kit so much and I wanted to do it justice. But I decided to switch the placement of the glitter header and the Simply Gilded washi. So I just do that really quick and then move to the top of Saturday. For the weekend, I first placed down two of the glitter headers that came in the kit, and then I placed the weekend banner right over it, and I love this weekend banner. I think it's so pretty with the florals on the side. The first thing I marked on Saturday was just that I had a really lazy morning. I pulled in a Coffee Monsters Co. Emoti all bundled up, which I think is perfect to mark my morning because I have a blanket that looks exactly like that. And then I put down a to-do list with a heart checklist that I cut up into three hearts, and I marked a few things that I did that morning. I placed down a gold foiled edit sticker from Magic Prints Co. along with a gold foil laptop, which is also from Magic Prints Co. Underneath that, I placed down a movie marquee, which I think is from the kit, but if not, then it was part of my leftover stash. To mark that, I watched a Taiwanese movie on Netflix, and I've actually talked about this movie before. I absolutely love it. I initially watched it when we were in Taiwan, and then they actually started playing it on Netflix, and so if you're interested in checking that out, the movie is called Dear X. And then underneath that, I used a little things to mark where we got dinner. That night, we met up with my boyfriend's family for dinner because they were in town, and then we all attended a little music concert together in Long Beach, so that was really fun. I just wrote that in on the half box and then used a music sticker from Plans of the Nest to mark that. Before moving to Sunday, I decided that there was too much white space there at the top of Saturday, so I ended up just adding a couple strips of washi underneath where I wrote Lazy Morning, and then I actually switched out the Coffee Monsters Co. Emoti to a different one instead. On Sunday, I first put down a today header, and that blue flag I put down was actually initially on Friday, and then I put down a microphone sticker from Love Shira over that. It came in like a record sticker, so I just cut off the record text next to it and used the microphone on its own because I had a wonderful karaoke sesh by myself on Sunday morning, which is always so much fun to just like sing your heart out and everything. Anyways, then I put down a flag with a boba sticker from Very Cute Designs to mark that we went and got some boba on Sunday. I put down a glitter header with a full box, and I believe that planner sticker came in the kit. If not, it was part of my leftover stash, but I could swear that that looks just like Hello Petite Paper's drawing, so I'm pretty sure it's from her. I did film when I got home, so I used that planner sticker along with a gold foiled film sticker from Magic Prints Co. And then after that, I did do a workout, so I put down a workout shoe sticker from Paper and Milk. And at this point, I realized that I forgot to put down a strip of the Simply Gilded washi, and I wanted to include that. So I lift everything up and put down a piece of the washi above the boba sticker. After replacing everything, I moved to the bottom, and to mark the rest of the day, I just put down a four-heart checklist. I cut it into four hearts and then used a header on top of that. I did have to trim off a little bit of the full box so that there was some space in between, And then I pulled in this guitar playing girl sticker from Kina Prince. She's so cute because on Sunday I just had this like burst of inspiration, and it's been forever since I've played my guitar, but I did bust it out and play a few songs, which was really hard to do because my calluses have completely gone away. So my fingertips like really hurt, but it was still really fun. And the last thing I do before I move to my sidebar is I switched the color of the little thing on Monday. And I think it was because I wanted more dark blue at the bottom of Monday. I felt like it wasn't dispersed very well. So I used a lighter blue little things on top and then changed the bottom one to the navy blue color. Now I'm just filling out my sidebar, and like I said, I kind of just combined the weekend together, and that is pretty much it for my spread. And now I'm just showing you these stickers that I have left. I definitely have quite a bit left over, and I'm just going to stick these into my leftover stash that I'm going to be giving away pretty soon. So probably in the next couple videos, I'll be doing a giveaway, and so if you're interested in that, then be on the lookout. So basically, that is it for my spread this week. I think this came out so gorgeous. I'm so obsessed with this kit. I just love Hello Petite Paper's artwork, and I just always think that no matter what you do, you just can't go wrong. It always looks great. And so yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you have any questions, just leave them down below, and I'll try to get to you as soon as I can. And as always, thank you so much for your support. I appreciate it endlessly, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye!